Tune into this week's episode of the DevOps Lab, where we're doing episode 2, and we're going to show you how to deploy a secretless app into Azure using Azure Key Vault. Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. We're running with episode number 2, and we're going to be talking about security with serverless apps. So welcome back, Christos. Great to have you here.
It's great to be here.
Awesome.
Another exciting topic about security.
I know. So tell us, like, you're going to tell us why we need a secretless app and why secrets are bad, right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
So in the first episode, we covered the what and the how. Mm-hmm. Now we're going to look exactly at how to do things, but there's a line I really enjoy saying,
okay.
Hackers don't break in, they sign in.
I like that. Hackers don't break in, they sign in. All right.
We have done a fantastic job in making their lives a lot easier by mm-hmm. committing secrets to GitHub and keys and certificates. And all they have to do is just scan GitHub or other public repositories mm-hmm. for information like this. And then they use it to make their way into resources, whether it's through a storage account that's not secure, whether it's through a VM, username and password. Once they get their foot through the door, then it's a lot easier for them to break into the rest of the resources. So we want to eliminate that. We're either too lazy or too fast to think about the implications of committing these things into mm-hmm. source code.
Absolutely.
And that's what happens. Or social engineering, obviously, that's another way to get access. But that takes too much effort. It's a lot easier to just scan the web to find that.
Find those passwords, yeah.
If you know your way through Google, then you can also find web configs that could be exposed to the world or other JSON files that could have secrets. So trust me, there's a lot of information. Please do not scan the internet. This is like public disclosure. You could be in serious trouble. But the information's out there if you want to do bad.
Yeah, and a lot of companies do get targeted, and yep. there are holes in their infrastructure, there's holes in their code, et cetera. Yep. So we need to find ways to eliminate that.
Exactly.
So how can we eliminate it? How do we resolve this? What do we do as next steps?
Well, the best thing to do is to eliminate secrets, mm-hmm. hence the secretless apps.
Okay.
But they need to live somewhere. So we can't live without secrets. You have connection strings, you have keys to other APIs. Mm-hmm. This is information that we need to use for to make our application run. So the best way to do that is to offload that somewhere else. Okay. Back in the day, we used to do SQL, like we would store all our secrets in SQL, mm-hmm. but you still have to access SQL somehow, so there's a connection right. string. What if we could eliminate everything?
Okay.
Right? And that's where Key Vault and Azure Active Directory come into play. If you are running anywhere, you can use Azure Active Directory and Key Vault to help you offload that. So Key Vault becomes the focal point for storing all the sensitive information. Azure Active Directory becomes the gatekeeper, and your application, all it needs to know is how to access Key Vault without having to authenticate again through secrets.
Cool. So can you show us how to set this up?
Absolutely. Cool. So let's do a demo on how you can use Azure Active Directory with Key Vault and the Azure SDK libraries to achieve that.
Okay.
Perfect. So let me switch to my screen. And here, I have an app that I have already built, so we don't have to go through the pain of building it. And we're going to quickly navigate through the code. So this is a .NET application, by the way. Everything I show also gets supported by Python and Node and Go, because the libraries that we have for Azure Active Directory and Azure Identity and the Azure SDKs are available in multiple languages. So awesome. What I show here, it's also achievable in other languages. I have a lot of underlines here because I need to do a restore. Switching branches, that's what happens. Anyway, so here we have two things. One is some settings that I've put into my app settings, but I don't want them to be accessible through code.
Right.
And I'm using Key Vault at startup to populate that. There's a builder extension for the configuration to add Key Vault, and you'll notice that all I need here is a credential builder, which is part of the Azure Identity, and a link to my Key Vault. Okay. But there is no secret anywhere.
Awesome.
And you can define how you authenticate. There is a default Azure credential that can do a lot of things. I will try to get secrets from the less secure to the most secure, starting with environmental variables, all the way to using a mask identity. Now, obviously, on my local machine, I don't have a mask identity, so I'm using the Azure CLI. And then when I switch to a production environment, It will use the chain token credential to go through the list of credentials and find the right one. So I always like to be explicit as well, because I need to know which account is used when it authenticates against Azure. If it uses my Visual Studio or Visual Studio Code account, it can have a lot more privileges, and we want to eliminate that super privileged account.
We want to use the least amount of privileges required to do the task.
Because many developers will have access to production systems, mm-hmm. and they will have contributor rights or sometimes owner rights to an Azure subscription. We want to use a service principal or a master identity in production to do that. And then this allows us to bootstrap the application when it starts. So ASP.NET does this clever thing that it bootstraps everything. It populates any environmental variable it finds in the app settings that matches in name. And then later on, I have another page where I want to explicitly call a secret at runtime. So not at startup, but at runtime, I want to say, go and grab me a secret. So this page here, the Key Vault Secrets model, does exactly the same thing. It will try to authenticate against my Key Vault client using my Azure identity credentials, and then go and pull a secret. This is not the best design. This is mainly for demo. Ideally, you will have probably a singleton for your Key Vault client, and you will be passing it through dependency injection through your application. But just this is a simple example. So let's run it and see what happens. .NET run. And we have similar examples for Node and Python, exactly the same principles. And now it's going to use the account I have in my CLI. Hopefully it hasn't timed out. If it has, we'll do an AZ login again and we'll pick it up. God, this is slow, okay. And now I can open the page in the browser. The fact that it started up front means that we are already connected to Key Vault, because it wouldn't start up otherwise. You would get an exception saying, I can't access Key Vault, or the account that you're using does not have permissions to Key Vault. So here you can see I'm pulling I'm a config secret. And then when I jump into my page, which is tiny, has some secrets there, now I can easily go into my Key Vault and change things in runtime. This is what IT Ops will be doing. They will be managing the secrets for you. You as a developer don't have to know what the secrets are or how they work. So you can develop against a dev environment in local, and then when you move to production without any code changes, you get the exact same benefits. So KV secrets.
So we want to do this in our development environments, our other environments. So if we have stage changes, i.e. Yes. dev, test, pre-prod, canary environments, we want to have this configuration for all of the
exactly.
environments.
Exactly.
Okay.
So I'm going to change it to a surprise name. Let's see if you're going to guess it.
Is it the DevOps Lab?
Oh, come
Is it
on.
April is amazing? Because that would be pretty cool.
There you go. And lo and behold, it happens. So IT Ops manage, your admins will manage the secrets. You as a developer, all you have to know is, which secret do I need to consume to connect to Key Vault? Which secret do I need to connect to SQL? And therefore, we eliminate secrets from our code base.
Awesome. That's really cool.
Yeah.
So we know how to deploy a secretless app. We know how to use Key Vault.
Yes.
Wicked. So we've taken those secrets out. Awesome. Well, thank you, everyone, for joining today. We have learned how to pretty much make our apps secretless in our code, which will secure our apps even further. So tune in next time as we go into more topics about security for developers and CI/CD with DevOps.